2019 happening here at the Uganda Red Cross Society. This is the Mapathon. It's I think either the third or second Mapathon we've ever had at the National Society here. We are very excited to have about 54 volunteers from the Red Cross, including other community members in Uganda. We have the Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team, Uganda team is here supporting the Mapathon. We have the Map Uganda team is also here. And we have other people from other organizations that are here, but mostly we have, I think, over 40 volunteers from the Uganda Red Cross Society. This is a very good step, and we want to thank, of course, the National Society here that is going ahead to engage the volunteers and building their capacity in creating map data in OpenStreetMap. OpenStreetMap is a platform that many humanitarian agencies like the Red Cross, the International Federation of the Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies, the Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team, American Red Cross and many others, MSF, are using this platform to create map data that in case of an event of a disaster, in case of a flooding, in case of, for instance, a landslide, this map data can be used to support these communities. And this is the beginning here at the Uganda Red Cross Society. The administration here is really very interested in this, and the volunteers, we have over 40 volunteers here who are very interested in learning more about this mapping platform, using the different tools that are available in OpenStreetMap, editing OpenStreetMap, doing the remote mapping, using the different satellite imagery sources. And so we think this is a very good step going forward. We want to thank the Federation, which is actually funding this GeoWeek Mapathon. IFRC, thank you so much. Going forward, this is the direction we would really like the National Society to take and the volunteers, so that we can create map data across the country, in the different parts of the country. Right now, what we are mapping is Eastern Uganda, and in about 9 sub-counties, we have created a mapping task on the hot tasking manager. This mapping task is being used by these volunteers to create map data in that area. These sub-counties in 4 districts have been identified as the flooding hotspot sub-counties of the district, of the districts. So we are creating map data in those areas, and we hope that going forward we can actually continue doing this in other parts of the country, and then the entire country will be put on the map, will be mapped. Right now, Uganda, we could say, is probably, this is a rough guess, it's about 40% mapped in OpenStreetMap. So we still have a lot to do to put the communities and other places on the map. And so we want to give a shout out and a big thank you to the community members who continue to map Uganda and map the different parts of the country here in Uganda. So thank you so much, Ugandan community members, but as well as the global OSM community. You are doing a great job, and in an event like this, we have support of so many volunteers around the world, and we want to say thank you so much to all of you.
Thank you. important to me, especially in my branch, and the way I'm going to employ it. Actually, first of all, I didn't know anything about street mapping, but today I've learned a lot, and I'm going to employ it in my branch. For instance, as Red Cross, as we really needed this so much, it helps you map the area, know in case of any disaster, you know where exactly to go, where to rescue people from. So it's going to help us a lot, because first of all, initially we didn't know. You just, if anything happens, like any disaster, you just go like a team to rescue, not knowing where to rescue from, all that stuff. So it's going to help us map the areas, for example, the flood affected areas. It would be so important for us.
We are from acquiring a skill of online street mapping, and generally we have acquired that skill very well, and it helps us in humanitarian assistance in this week. We are in cases where we have floods, people can easily be moved, houses can easily be detected. Then
to attend training at Cross Headquarters. This was a training whereby we were taken through how to draw maps and upload data. It has been a fruitful experience because I have learned how to upload the data from our various branches. As someone who hails from a disaster-stricken region of the country, and that is from the Gisu region where we constantly invest in flats, I've learned that we can upload maps, ascertain where people, the buildings, communities, where they are located in particular areas, and try to come up with ways that we can mitigate these people from being affected by the various disasters that they are faced with. This, whatever knowledge I've attained today is what I'm willing to share with most of my members in my community and in my branch. We need to be sure that even the people at the grassroots know what is happening, and the only way we can reduce on the effects they will face after the disaster has struck is by using such interventions in this process, so as we can mitigate and reduce the damage that will be caused when the catastrophe comes.